For literally years, you've heard me say, keep your shoulders down and back, keep your shoulders down and back. In this video, we're going to look at what that means and why it's so important and why I recommend it. For somebody over 50, I have pretty good pec development. I chalk this up to two factors. One, the fact that I focus on squeezing exercises as much as the pushing exercises. And second, and probably more importantly, the fact that I keep my shoulders down and back when I do my chest exercises. Not only does it make you stronger, but it keeps your shoulders safe from injury. We'll talk more about how this position can increase your strength later in the video, but right now let's talk about the shoulder safety. Your shoulder is an incredibly flexible joint, but to keep it from being injured, you have to stabilize it while you're working out. Before we go any further, let me show you what this means, keeping your shoulders down and back. So, shoulders up, down, forward, back. So we keep them down and back. Thrust your chest out and pretend you're trying to squeeze something and hold it between your shoulder blades. So, shoulders up, down, forward, back, down and back, chest thrust out. That is the stabilization position that you should use for all chest, lat, and shoulder exercises. It's really difficult at first, but after a while it becomes second nature to hold that position. Let me show you another example. This is a little easier to visualize. I'm going to take some blue tape and put it on my ear. And I'm going to take a piece of tape and put it on my shoulder. Another way to think of this is keep the tapes apart. Keep your shoulder away from your ear. So your shoulders are down and back. Pull-ups. Up position, down position. I'm keeping the shoulders down and back. What a lot of people do, when they go up, notice they do this. The tapes are touching. No, you try to keep them apart as much as you can. So that's how you do it. Now let's talk about the strength increase from keeping your shoulders down and back. That's what most of you are interested in. Why is it that keeping the shoulders down and back with the chest thrust out increases your strength? It's because of leverage. Let's look at how the shape of your shoulders and chest change when you pack your shoulders. So notice these two pieces of tape. Those will become important in a second. This is a normal position. Now, when I pack my shoulders, notice what happens. My shoulders become narrower and my chest is thrust out. Notice what happens to the angle between the tapes. Now it's more upright, and in the normal position, it's almost more horizontal. Let's look at my professional anatomical drawing. The top image has the shoulders relaxed. In this case, the shoulders are wide and the chest is not up in the air. In this case, the pecs pull almost horizontally on the upper arm bone. However, in the bottom image, you see the shoulders packed. They're scrunched together, the shoulders are narrow, the chest is thrust up in the air, and the pecs are pulling at a much higher angle on the upper arm, so they have much higher leverage. Now let's look at my handy dandy little model. So this is your shoulder joint, this is your chest, and this is your arm. This rubber band represents the pec muscle. It pulls on the arm to make the arm go forward. Now, this is the dumbbell we're carrying. We're gonna put this on here. Okay? Let's look at how leverage affects how much weight you can lift. Now, if you're good at packing your shoulders, you can lift from about this angle because your chest is thrust up in the air. Now, notice I barely have to pull with my pec at all to get that dumbbell to come up. Now, on the other hand, say I'm not packing my shoulders. It pulls more at an angle like that because my chest is not thrust out. Now, with this, you have to pull really hard before your pec can get that weight to come up because you're not using leverage to your advantage there. So if you want to lift a lot of weight, use mechanical efficiency and leverage and get your chest thrust up in the air and make your shoulders narrow to get the weight to go up easily. So after all these years of me saying, keep your shoulders down and back, I finally explained to you why it's so important. Why? Quick quiz. Two reasons. First reason, decreases the chance of injury because it stabilizes your shoulder. Second reason, because it makes you stronger, and most of us like that second reason. It's part of the reason I think I have such good pec development, is because I increase my strength with the proper position of the shoulders. That is it for this week. Auf Wiedersehen.